Hello, this is Alex, and welcome back to my underground Let's Play. Today I want to make some huge changes to my spider trap setup because even though it's working, it's not as efficient as I would like it to be. I need to move these guys through these tubes here and push them with water, and they sometimes get stuck when they fall down or try to climb back up. And what the? Excuse me, but I've never seen that before. A slime just fell out of my. Did you guys see that? A slime just fell out of the farm up there. How weird. Oh well. So what I want to do is I want to expand these rooms quite a bit. Because they are nowhere near big enough to have a proper spawn rate, and I'd like that to be the case. So I'm gonna start doing that. No, I don't want to go down here. You stupid spider. Okay, good thing I have my. I got the silk touch on this diamond pickaxe, so I can just take down the glass. And I want to get rid of this water, okay? So, I'm gonna do that. It's gonna be a very large build. It's gonna take me a lot of time, but I thought you might want to see the progress that I'm doing on the way. So, I'm not gonna record it all because it's gonna take me a lot of time to figure out where I want to do what and how to set it up. And I saw Doug M's video today. He got 500 spiders in his system, and that's a huge amount. I thought I had a lot when I had 160 spiders in my system, but 500, oh man. And he got a lot of XP from it. So if I can make mine more effective, that would be nice. And also, there are some things about the setup that I wasn't aware of when I made mine, like the spiders try and track you. So if I'm, let's see, the spiders spawn in there. Oh, it's hard to see from down here. Hang on. I'm gonna remove this wall. See, the spiders spawn here, and I'm standing over there somewhere. So they're gonna fall down and get stuck on this wall around here. And I want them to go over here, so I try to push them with the water, but the small spiders are capable of fighting against the currents, and I didn't know that either. I knew they were. I've seen them be able to move about a lot, but I didn't know that they were that strong. So I want to make it so the hole in which they're gonna go through needs to be. So I can stand in an area and they're gonna try and track me the way I want it to. And these spiders over here, let's see, they're in here somewhere. They are trying to get to me when I'm standing over here. They're trying to get to me through this side here. Like this. Oops, oh, probably a bad idea. Oh no, what happened? Oh. Oh well, a few torches got washed away there. So I gotta change this setup, and what I gotta do is I'm gonna rip out the entire rooms. I'm gonna leave the spawners and make a huge room around it for them to spawn in. So it's gonna take some time, and it's gonna be a lot of work, but I don't mind. But I can't do it all on camera because that's going to take way too much time. But I'm going to turn the camera on now and then and show you my progress. And well, let's take it from here. Now I gotta find that. Where is he? Probably out here somewhere. Over here? Oh, it's getting louder. Is he above me? Oh well, you've seen me kill these guys plenty of times. I'm gonna kill him, get on with it, and I'll get back to you. See you shortly. Okay, so I removed the area around the spawner here. I think this is the size of room they need. I think they can spawn in up to four spots away. So I may need to actually build the wall out here. So that this is the outer wall over here. And the same at this side. I don't quite know, but I think that's going to be the size of the room. And then have them drop down in water and move them, towards this point over here at ground level. Because if I remember correctly, the spawner up there is at the same level as the spawner up here. We can just check that. So we fell down here. It's not gonna be the first time. Go away, water. Ah, stupid. Okay, so this is the spawn. This is at eye level now, and I'm at 15. Okay, so I'm gonna go stand at eye level with the other spawner. That's here, eye level. 15, so that's perfect. They're at the same height, so I can make them drop the same distance and move here somewhere in the middle. And make sure that the area in which they go through, in which I route them through, is gonna correspond with the spot I need to stand in for them to try to get to me and then follow the stream. So now I gotta build a room around this and dig it out all the way down to the floor. And I just normally do stuff like this with dirt, just to get a feel for how large things are gonna get before I start. And it's easier to visualize it, and it's very fast to remove again. So I'm gonna continue, and I'll get back to you. So there isn't much left here. I removed most of the glass over to the machine, the thingy there. And I started digging out this area in here, and it's going to be a huge area, as you can see. Whoops. And I just went through another iron pickaxe, so now I thought I'm just going to make a diamond one. I got the other two here. Fortune is for when I find coal and such, and silk touch is for taking down glass. So I guess that's the way it's going to be in Minecraft now, when you are crafting a lot. You're gonna get unbreaking. That's nice. It's gonna last a long time. So I maybe should put a railing up there. Oh well, because these huge projects here, you're gonna dig and dig and dig, and you're gonna go through a lot of pickaxes. And when you're out looking for materials and such, you have pickaxes that has certain abilities on them or enchants, and I'm not going to use my silk touch pickaxe for any other purpose than when I need the silk touch ability on it. I'm not going to use it for this kind of job, for instance. So for taking down glass and taking down glowstone, and maybe, I don't know, I can also pick up redstone blocks. I tried that. What's in here? Oh, that's my mine thingy. Oh, that's gonna get in the way. Okay, well, we're gonna figure that out somehow. Well, this is gonna be a huge room. But that's good. And the best part is, when I'm done, I've got a whole nother one I gotta do over the other one. So I'm just gonna crack on. It almost looks like you cut a building in half here. You got these apartments you can look into. Okay, so I hit the bottom floor here. Now I gotta build up the walls, figure out some kind of water system, and then go do the other one. Okay? Okay, so The room is square and empty now, and I closed off the roof, and now I'm gonna go down there, collect my stuff, and see if any mobs is gonna fall on my head. So let's just close this and go down here. It's quite a drop. I may need to raise it up too, because it may be too far drop. I don't know if it's necessary to be this high. And also, I don't know if the distance from here to where I'm gonna stand over there is gonna be too far. But well, the spawner is in the same place, and I used to stand around here. So this is okay. This is up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So maybe I should raise it a few, maybe up to there or something. But we'll see. Let's turn on to see what happens. Should be dark up there, enough for them to spawn. I had it on peaceful while I worked up there because, well, it's just too dangerous. And if not, I wonder if it's broken now. Or maybe it's too light, but there's plenty of light around. Oh, here comes one. Hello. I'm gonna try and remove these. Okay, see if this makes a difference. Wow, it's dark up there. That didn't help. Whoa! Okay, four at once. I'm just gonna try it out on easy now because I don't wanna die during this. Okay, two more. Nice. Come on. I didn't know they could actually spawn in midair like this. But that's great. Come on, you. So what if I go over here? Oh shoot! Okay, that was four again. They caught me off guard. What if I go over here? They should rush towards this opening, I guess. Spawn you! What's the spawn rate of these? Is one every 25 seconds or around that, I think. Okay, go. So it's working. I'm gonna turn it off again now and bring this back to 75. Yes, I see you. So maybe I should, yeah, if I'm gonna stand at this level here, normally I stand here or here. So this is 11 and the floor here is 8. 9, 10, 11. So if I'm up here, so I actually need to have the roof at this, or the floor at this level. I'm gonna think about that. Maybe I'm gonna make the other room like that, with the floor ending at 11, and see what happens. So I'll get cracking. So I'm over at the other spawner now, and I'm just gonna do the same, rip it all out. Come on, good. And lower the roof. Oh, I can test it. I should get the block. Yep, that's funny. I don't know what I'm gonna use it for, but. And I noticed something, I did this earlier too, but I got two different. Okay, now they stack, but I, in my chest, over at near my bed, I got two stacks of these, One has got two of these, it's like this. So one has two and one has one, and I cannot put them together, even though they got the same label. It's not the same, I don't know. Something seems to be messing it up, so. Oops. Okay, so this is just back to square one. I'm gonna keep this here machine in the middle, most of it, so, and then I'm gonna fall down. So I know where I used to stand for a lot of the spiders to spawn. I've gotta get rid of this water here. Yoink. Good. Okay, I'm gonna crack on, ripping this out and to pieces. I just realized something. The room in here, with the size it's gonna have to be, we're gonna have to evacuate Mr. Chicken down here, I think. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna try and do that as humanely as possible. So, but I think we have to do that. He's gonna get in our way if we don't. Oh, that was wrong. Okay, so I'm making progress. It's slow, but it's okay. It's a lot of work. These are huge rooms. But if it's gonna give us a better XP machine, I don't mind doing the work. I'm listening to music in my headphones, which I'm just turning off when I'm talking to you guys. And I'm having fun, so I'll see you shortly. I raised the floor in here, the three I talked about. If we go out here and go downstairs, we can see it. So this is the floor before, and I just raised it up three. And we have this floor in here now. And I counted from this is where the spawner is up there, and I counted out 16, and that ends up here. I went in here, and from this, where the spawner is up there, I counted out 16 this way, and that ended up over here, around where I'm standing now. But, oh, yeah, okay. But as you can see, these are the meeting points from these two spawners in there. But this is too far away. I can't make this the meeting point. Because even though I'm only like 13 or something from that one in there, I'm 19 or 20 from the one in there. So what I had to do was, I have to move the spiders when they fall down from up there. I have to move them with water over to this area over here and push them down a corridor and have them collect here somewhere. Well, this is where I gotta stand, because to this spot here is 16, so if I'm standing, I used to stand here. So that made good sense, because I didn't know that, but this was about 14 or 15 from each of the spawners. This point here I'm standing on. I didn't know that. I just found out that if I stood here, more spawned. So, but that's what I have to do. So now I have to figure out how to move them out there. And I'll get cracking on that now. It looks like this room is working well. I've just been fooling around with the water, trying to find out how to get it to all flow towards this one corner over here. And I think I figured it out. I don't know yet if it's gonna be the problem if they wanna start climbing the walls, but I'll have to see. But it does seem like they spawn in groups now. And before they only spawned one at a time. So that's an improvement. It was just one before, but I've seen four spawn at once. one. Okay, three this time. Good, so I gotta get out of here. It's dangerous in here. And there's somehow tier two, yes. This is one crazy machine. Gotta close up this hole. Oh, and we got a sneaky one there as well. Yeah, I see you. Oh, you bastard, you still got me. Okay, so I think I got them. When they spawn in there, they get pushed down to the corner. You see, like that. There's a dead spot right there. But enough spiders should come by that they should just push each other onwards. That's my hope, anyways. Okay, so I got those rooted to this corner, and here comes some more, so that's good. Now I gotta do the same with the other ones, so I'm gonna do that now. I'm just trying it out now, and there seems to be a bit of a clog in the system here. They don't want to climb up there. You just join at this point, and this. And they both stop at this corner, and I was hoping they would climb up here. A few have, but not many. I want to be able to crush them and have them stay in the same location. Ow! And also, I don't seem to be able to get to the XP and such, so... I'm gonna have to work on it. Okay, I'm gonna try something really stupid now, but I'm pretty sure I'm either gonna die or have to run very far away. But I'm gonna unplug this, break this here, rock, and all the spiders are gonna come out. And there are lots up there. 40 and I don't know how many in that, and all the way down here. So, we're gonna have a lot of spiders on our hands. Or maybe not. Well, we did learn from previous machines that they don't like to swim down. So maybe I should have the water stop and let them fall down. Yeah, I don't know what to do yet. It's just this trial and error I'm talking about sometimes. You just gotta keep at it. Try new things. Maybe if I... Yeah. I'll see. Okay, so I made a few small changes here. And it seems to have helped. I lowered the chamber in which I want them to climb up into by one. They were up here before with the iron bar one above, so they had to climb up two and they kept falling down, but they seem to be more willing to just jump up there by themselves now. I also moved the water streams in closer to get more pressure on them. I don't know if that made any difference, but now, at least, they all want to go up into this little area. Let's see, I just turned it on, I already got 60. So, but there is a problem back here. I think I need to figure out some way to funnel them better into this one by one. Because sometimes they do have problem with that. It solves itself pretty quickly, as you can see. They bunch up in there and can't get through, and then suddenly five or six come through and they just hurry up and get in there and jump up to the others. So there's improvement here now. Oh, the lag. Also because I'm right on the edge between two chunks here, and with all these mobs, let's see, 68 already. So I get a lot of lag. Yeah, there are some in there. I guess they're climbing the walls or something. But they should get pushed over to this point right here, which is the end wall, and then come out here like this. See, here they come. They were climbing the walls. Yeah. And over here, they're probably bunched up around here somewhere. And when I get close here, they fall down. There's a dead spot there, but as well as here. But as soon as another spider comes along, it pushes the first one out of the way. 80. So it's pretty fast now. Now I've got to hook up the crushing mechanism and then maybe work some more on getting them funneled better. Because they get stuck in there. See? 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like trying to count live mice in a cage that's running around. You can't do it. Okay, so I'm gonna try and move this crushing mechanism down here, up here somewhere. I don't know quite where I'm gonna put it. Or maybe I should even, excuse me, maybe I should even move them from this place to another, maybe down here. But I don't know. It seems to work best when I'm standing right here, because then they are coming to this middle point and trying to get me, and these guys over here are trying to get me, so they're moving towards this point here. This is the end wall, so they get pushed out into this tube, and it works pretty well. I get a lot of spiders very fast. Let's see how many we got now. 95. So it's pretty quick. I'm gonna continue. I think I got it working now, besides this problem here. See, when one or more try to get in at the same time, they just bump each other out of the way. But yeah, it fixes itself. And they rush up here. What about these guys over here? Hey, you bums, wanna join the party? Okay, so they gather here in this holding area, and I set up the crusher and the stopper again. When I press this button, this I think it's an RS knowledge here, sends a signal to the piston over here, the top one, and starts crushing these guys. And then a secondary signal goes all around these pistons, creating a huge delay. And when it gets back here, it resets this RS knowledge and stops sending the signal. Now, I'm not very good with redstone, so I'm not 100% sure about how it works, but I can use it. And it's not very complicated, as you can see. And over here, ow. I just set up a simple lever here, which goes to the bottom piston here, and when I pull this, it just blocks the single hole below them here, so no more can get up into this area. And so they are just gonna have to wait their turn. But I am gonna go get myself some hand grenades. So you bums stay in the holding area. I want to see if this works. I haven't actually tried it yet with one of these. Let's get a few of these. I hope they didn't despawn. That doesn't sound like it. Okay. I don't know how many we got here. I want to collect. I can't collect items when it's this full. Okay, from this area I can, but when it's empty I can collect it right here in this area. When the spider's in here and I walk up to it, yeah, you see, they just push me out of the way. So, how many do we have? Only 60? Well, it has only been on for, I don't know, 1.5 minute or something. So let's stop this, start crushing. A few are gonna die because some take fall damage in there. Maybe more than a few. I can change the delay over there, and I may have to do that. But let's see about this now. Yoink. And I can stand here and collect the XP. Ooh, that's nice. Well, not many were in there, but let's open this so they can start gathering again. And I'm gonna remove some of these ticks on these. So I got 14 repeaters here, and 12 of them are set at 4. So I think I'm gonna, let's see, this, set this at 2 instead. So, 2 less ticks. Oh, 30 already. Man, this is fast. It's way faster than the old one. It's taken me forever to build, but it's okay, it's a fun project. And I get something very good out of it, I can use. So I'm gonna let this accumulate, watch the video, and when I think it's ready to try again, I'll turn on the camera. See you shortly. Okay, I'm back. I've let it collect for 15 minutes or so, and I don't actually know how many is in there because, well, you can see the amount of lag I get. But let's see if we can. No. Oh. Got 5 frames per second. I need to go up and push the buttons. Come on, you can do it. Oh, the lag. It's horrible. Pull the. And then jump up there and. Select the bomb. Throw it. Uh-oh. What happened? 0 frames. 1. 0. 1. Oh, 2. Oh my god. I can't play this. I just need to collect the items. What happened? Did I fall through the ground? This is ridiculous. Where am I? Oh, I'm down here. Come on. I'm gonna try and see if I can get up there. One more. Turn around. No, that's too far. Yes, come on. And walk over there. I'm sorry about the bad porn movie sounds, but I'm really trying to collect these things. No! Jump! Jump! Okay. Okay, my inventory is apparently full. Away with that. Let's see about the XP. I got 3 frames now. 4. 5. Let's see. What was that? Was that 11 or 12 or something? Wow, it's fast. So, last I checked, there were about 280 in there. And then I let it run for another 5 minutes, so I don't know how many that is in all, so maybe 300, 350 or something. But this is a nice way to get XP. Wow, that's a lot. My inventory is just, I've got 30 frames again now, so that's good. Just full stuff. Okay, so from 12 to 21. Open up, let them back in. Whew! That was fun. So, you don't have to watch me do this. So, I think this is a vast improvement over the last design I had. I need to clean up down there and figure out something and maybe hide this up here. I can just build a wall around it or something. Because there is a free space. I left a free space here so I can build up around. But I don't know. We'll see. So that's it for today. I'm glad I got this done and I'm glad I got to share it with you. So I hope some of you can use this and it can prove helpful to you. Okay. See you next time and thanks for watching again. Bye.